What's up, my love bugs and love muffins? It's Mama Love, and I am back with a video, a special video. It's special because you know how you always want to give back, but you don't know how, especially with a person that has everything already. And the best thing that you can do for a person when you can't give them something that they already have is give them something that's treasurable to their heart. And nothing like a mother's home-cooked meal. So that's what I plan on doing today. I plan on cooking my firstborn's favorite meal. Stay tuned. What's up, love bugs and love muffins? I'm preparing a big dinner for my firstborn pregnant daughter. That's what I'm calling, my pregnant child. She did something for me special, but I wanted to do something for her in return. So I'm making my famous dressing. I got all my stuff for my dressing. I'm not gonna show y'all my whole recipe, but this is my stuff for my dressing. I'm making homemade mac and cheese. I'm making smothered pork chops with gravy, and I'm making green beans and white potatoes. So I just want y'all to stay tuned. Y'all gonna see it going down today. And not Martha Stewart, but Reba Stewart. Okay, so right now I'm making chicken and dressing. I'm not gonna be something real serious, but here's my chicken. I'm putting a place in the oven. Just a little small chicken though, just for the flavor. And I always add, you know, along with my pan of buttermilk cornbread. But I'm not gonna show y'all all my recipes. So, yeah. I done cut onions and now I'm over here crying. So I'm chopping up my celery and onions because it's gonna go in my beef stock. I mean my chicken stock. So I just wanna show y'all what I'm doing. In my crock pot, I'm gonna be putting this to work because it's gonna cook slowly anyway. So I'm going to go ahead in my crock pot, I'm going to add my chicken broth. I use 2 boxes. Yeah. Open that for me, Ajahnay, baby. My other box. Oh, just give me one. This is for my good flavoring, y'all. I like to have flavor. I use 1 packet of the recipe Lipton onion mix. Okay. I'm gonna also pour that over in my stock. It gives it a good onion flavor. And also, here is my chopped celery and onions. I'll go ahead and slide that on down. There's my stock. There's my chicken stock. There is my Lipton onion soup mix. And I'm gonna add water to this. Pour my water. That is gonna, let me one more, because I want this filled to the top. And I'm gonna put the top on. I'm gonna let that be over here simmering while my chicken is in the oven baking. And next I'll be making my cornbread. Okay, that's that. We're gonna put this on, let's see what we want. I want it on high. Yeah. Cook that fast, baby. Let that be sitting. I got my pot boiling for my mac and cheese. I'm boiling my noodles now. And I'm only gonna use this box, it's 2-pound box, so I'm going to use 1 box and a, I ain't measuring, you know how black folks is, 1/4. Yeah, that's about 1/4, that's good. All right, so that'll be boiling. I'm gonna put a stick of butter in that while I'm coming over here, and I'm gonna cut up my Velveeta block cheese. Okay, so what I have right here is I got my Velveeta already chopped up in the bowl, waiting. I got my butter that I'm gonna use, it's already sliced up. And I bought mozzarella and cheddar, mild cheddar, and I also bought sharp cheddar. Inside of it already has it with a touch of Philadelphia cream cheese. I could not find, I got my half and half. I could not find my Kobe Jack cheese and Monterey Jack. could not find it. They did not have it in the store. So this is what I'm using. Right now I am prepping my cornbread for my dressing. And here we go. Cups of cornmeal, but since I'm doubling this, I am going to four cups.
Oh,
here's my cup. Here's my cup. Okay. So I'm measuring it on this because this is my, look how I'm doing that, so sloppy. But that's okay. Okay, that's one cup. Let me do this a little bit better than that. Oh, I went to the store, y'all, and forgot to grab batteries for my thing. There's two cups.
3 cups.
4 cups. My kids love my dressing, y'all, so. Yes, I'm overdoing it. It requires 1 egg, but I'm doubling it, so I'm gonna use 2 eggs. It also requires 1/3 cup of vegetable oil, so I'm gonna use 2. What was that other ingredient? The milk.
Yes, the milk requires 1 cup of milk and 1/3.
For the milk, I'm gonna pour 1 cup, but since I'm doubling it, I'm gonna pour 2 cups. Also required 1/3, I'm gonna pour 1/3. Doubling it, I'm gonna pour another 1/3. That's the best way I do it. And that is my, for my cornbread. And I'm going to take in my cornbread. I'm done mixing my cornbread batter. I'm going to pour it over in the pan. And she's going in the oven. Okay, so on the stove, I'm going to pour my half and half. I'm gonna use 2 cups of that. Here's my 1 stick of butter chopped. I'm gonna use 2 cups of my mild cheddar. This is why I don't like to measure nothing, y'all, because I ain't got time for all this. I believe in the cheese, so really I shouldn't be measuring it, but I want to use 2 different kinds. So, and then I'm going to use my mozzarella and cheddar. Don't be scared of the cheese, y'all. That's my motto when I'm making mac and cheese. I'm always asked to make it at functions because I am not afraid of the cheese. There's that cup, 2 cups of that. Here's my sharp cheddar. Here goes my sharp cheddar. Now I'm pouring in 2 cups of that as well. This is so fun. I love doing this. Also, Velveeta cheese. Don't be afraid of the cheese. I'm gonna go ahead. Put my Velveeta cheese in. I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid. And I'm gonna do my 2 eggs. And from the looks of this cheese, I might just add 1 more cup of half and half, but I'm gonna take and stir it in all together till it comes to a melt. I'm gonna add my own directions, and I'm going to add another cup of half and half, because I'm telling you now, I don't like the way that's looking, and I believe it. If it's gonna be creamy, let it be creamy. Let it do what it do, because I'm gonna add more cheese too, y'all. So, and it's gonna come to a melt. You'll see the results next. So as you can see, it came to a nice melt. Just a few chunks in it, a nice melt. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is, I'm gonna add my mac. Kinda hard doing this with one hand, but I'm gonna get it. This is not all the mac, I'm just adding a few at a time. So I wanna stir in, I want it to be creamy, y'all. It's gotta be creamy. If it ain't creamy, it ain't cheesy. If it ain't cheesy, it ain't mac. Look at how that fell in there. Jesus, Lord, help me, Lord. Okay. Just a few little macaronis. And so we want that cheese, so that cheese is gonna, let me turn this off. But that cheese is all in that.
Stupid.
We got cheese is God's, the cheese represents God's love, y'all. And the macaronis is us. So we want to make sure we get all of God's love all wrapped around us, y'all. We just want God's love all over us. Yes. God's love. Don't that look good, y'all? All right. So we're going to go ahead and pour it on into the pan. I can't see from that side, Terrell, the way you're pouring it, but I guess it's all right. I want to make sure I get all that. I can't see. I can't. Okay. That's my cheese, y'all. That's my mac and cheese. I mean, I don't want to miss no cheese. Hold up. Oh, set that to the side. And what I'm going to do is I have a remainder left here. I'm just going to go ahead and add that because I have more room to add anyways. This is the mac and cheese. We're the macaroni. God is the love. And he's surrounding us. Surrounding us with the love. There's some anointed macaroni and cheese, y'all. Now that I got that all spread it through my mac as I want it. On each corners. Four corners of the earth. We make sure we got that cheese. Oh, there is not a mac in here that don't have cheese on it. There is not a human being in here that don't have God's love on him or her. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and just spread this out before I put it in the oven though. This is what I'm gonna do. No, I know I'm greedy. I want every last, yes. I'm going to go ahead and top it off with the rest of the cheese. This is the rest of the mozzarella and cheddar. Ain't God good? All the time. All the time, God is good. And no matter if I didn't get it all over, because, honey, this is cheesy. This is Tina and Queen's. But matter of fact, this is all my kids' favorite. This is all their favorite dish. Next step, I'm over here seasoning my pork chops. We're gonna have the smothered pork chops. So all I'm gonna do is add Lori's seasoning salt and black pepper. And I'm gonna do that on each side. This was requested by Queen. I asked her what does she want me to make her. Her favorite dinner dish. I wanted to do something really special, close to the heart, and ain't nothing like mama's cooking. So, I'm cooking her favorite meal. And along with the rest of the kids, but I want to do something special for her. Since she, you know, she has everything, I don't know what to get Queen now. God has blessed her tremendously, and she can have anything she wants. But one thing about it is you can't go out, you can go to any restaurant you want to go to. There ain't gonna be no restaurant like your mama's home cooked meals. Ain't nobody gonna cook like mama. And I'm just gonna drop my chops right over in there like that. Oh, scissorizo, scissorizo, scissorizo. Hold on, let me get me a fork, y'all. You know how we do. I'm gonna let this just be the four in there. I'm not gonna put another one in, but I'm gonna do four at a time, y'all. Okay, y'all, here we go. Got my green beans and white potatoes going that I've been doing so far. Those are almost finished. And I got these frying, but over here, bam! Yeah. That's cheesy. All right, and then I got my cornbread because I'm about to do my dressing in front of y'all. And here go my pork chops. I'm getting ready to prepare them for my smothered gravy. And y'all gonna see how I make my gravy. Okay, you all, so I am about to prep my dressing before you. This is how my chicken look. I was waiting on my chicken. Also, my cornbread is ready. This is my chicken. I wanted to make sure it was good and ready. You can tell how you say fall off the bone. I need all these pieces. I'm not gonna put a whole chicken inside of us thing. So I'm just doing this because I want to show y'all how the chicken looks. So I'm gonna put this camera down because I want y'all to see me in action. Now preparing my dressing. This is how I do it.
Trey, I don't know.
Hands are clean. So I'm getting my cornbread all together. This is how I do. Hands clean, by the way, y'all. My hands are clean. I don't play that dirty cook stuff. I was gonna use gloves, but I need to get my cornbread good.
Look like scrambled eggs.
Little bitty pieces. Of course, this is not to my liking as far as a lot of cornbread, so that's why I always get extra, and I always add stovetop chicken flavor. I add that for my fill-ins, my bread. I usually get about 3 of those, which I have one more since I didn't open it. As I'm getting this in here, mixing this up. I'm gonna go ahead and add my, this is what this was doing, you guys, when I had my, this is my broth over here. This is mixed with chicken broth, onion, celery, Lipton onion soup. This is what this mixed with. I don't like no dry dressing. That's how I prep my dressing. Everybody different now. That's how I'm doing mine. Y'all may do y'all's another way. There ain't no wrong or right way to do it. I'm gonna leave some of that in there. Of course, I got a lot of broth. I always like to make a lot of broth just in case. Turns out dry and all of that type of stuff. So we still got a little damp over here. I mean dry over here. You can, should none be in your dressing crunching. Your dressing should be smooth. If you, somebody made you some crunchy dressing, they wrong. If it's gonna crunch, at least it, that means it was in the oven and the top was on it. I'm gonna let y'all know, I do not add eggs to my dressing. I don't understand that. I feel like the bread to get itself along with the broth and whatever I put in it, like my cream of chicken and my cream of celery that I put in here.
Yeah, you don't want it too hard.
Yeah, I don't like no hard. I don't play that. I don't play that when it comes to my dressing. See how that's coming along, you all? All right. I got it wet enough for now, because what I'm gonna do is I'm going to go ahead and add my cream of chicken. It don't matter if it's Campbell's or it's Essentials. This is my kids' favorite. My kids love when I cook like this. That's why y'all say to say. Well, y'all used to say, y'all ain't gonna be able to say that. We getting that off. I'm like, ooh, they big, they all big. This is why I used to cook all the time. I ain't cooked like this in a long time. We used to always try to go on diets. Queen was the smallest thing in the house, talking about, that's not fair, y'all shouldn't try to starve me. So I'm cooking like this. So I'm saying, hey, why not? I'm gonna go all out for my whole family. Cause I love my family. I love my kids and kids to be. Yeah, see. Got it? That's in there all smooth like that?
Mm-hmm.
That's, to me, that was perfect. That was just enough. And guess what? I didn't even measure it. But I make it every year for years. So this is how I do it. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add my chicken pieces to it. Mm. Old chicken. I'm gonna try to put the skin in there. Y'all ain't gonna put the skin, but put the chicken. Oh Lord, it's hot. I don't wanna go to hell. Hell is hotter. My mama used to always say that. If I burnt myself or something, I'd be like, ooh, that's hot. She said, hell hotter. I always say that. And I want to get the lightest pieces of the, I don't want to get no, let me see what else I got here. I'm sorry, y'all. This big, I'm going to set this down here on the side. I don't want that skin. I don't want that skin. Hey. Stuff like that. Get some of that chicken up in there. A lot of chicken over here. We don't want to be stingy with the chicken. That's wrong. Don't be stingy. Stingy with the meat. Okay, so I just put a little, did you see this wetness here? I just added that chicken from here. Just a little, some of that chicken over in here too. Cause you can use that as well. So I use, try to use all the seasoning I can. You can see bits of chicken. My chicken is up in here. And see how moist that is? Ain't too less, it ain't too much. Okay, so I'm adding my seasonings. This is my ground sage. My black pepper. And I use a lot on top because I'm only going to add this one time. It's enough just to mix this whole, and my seasoning salt, I don't want too much. It's enough. I'm gonna use garlic powder, and I'm gonna use onion powder. Now I'm gonna mix. Queen wanted yams. It was just a short time to kind of like do it in. I knew it was gonna take me a long time. Cause like I say, I take a long time to, you know, prep all this food. You know, I ain't gotta cook for how many days, Terrell? How many gotta cook for?
About a week.
About a week. I don't know. I'm dressing good now, I don't know.
Well, yeah, most of it will be gone.
Okay, you all, so what I'm gonna do is, I like to spread it out even like that after I had seasoned it. So I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna pop this in the oven and you'll see results when it's finished. Okay. Now I'm about to show you how I prepared my homemade gravy, which I was taught by a friend of mine. She's my best friend, she's my mentor, everything. Give her a shout out to Joe. I'm pouring me a cup of oil. This is the same oil that was from my fried pork chops earlier. I'm going to add my garlic and onions over into it. And I'm gonna let this brown after I season it. I got my salt, I mean, this is my pepper, I'm sorry. Garlic powder. Yes, even though I have onions in it already, onion powder and garlic. I love garlic and onion, y'all. And Lori's seasoning salt. That's gonna fry. When that fries and that browns, I'm going to add flour. See how that fries real nice? After I add my flour to this, my flour is also going to brown until it's smoothed out. Then I'll add my cup of water or how many ever. The more the flour, the thicker the gravy. So I got a lot of pork chops. As you can see, I have some here to be smothered and also in the pan that I showed you earlier over here. Okay, and also I have to While I'm doing that, while that's browning, this is my green beans and white potatoes, which is ready. They're finished. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn that pot off. And like I said, I'm gonna let this be browning. I don't like to be the type of person that cook a meal and people be like, oh no, she can't cook. I'm not gonna have it said, y'all. I'm not gonna have it said that Mama Love can't cook. My kids will tell you, and whoever else know me, that I can burn, so yeah. Okay, you can see how it's coming along. Browning. I want like a, you have your gravy, whatever color you want it. I prefer a brown gravy. I got it to a brown where I want it. I'm adding my water. I'm gonna add this whole jug to the top, fills to the skillet. And a little bit more pepper. Then what I do is, since that's smoothed out already, I go ahead and I add my chops. And like I said, I have it on low, real low. And that's how it turns out. So that's my dressing. I just pulled out the oven and I'm preparing plates to take to my daughter Queen and Clarence. I made two plates. Okay, you all, so I'm finally done preparing the meal. I had not cooked like this in a long time, y'all. I'm not trying to go back to cooking like this, but it was requested. Well, not so much requested, cause I wanted to do this for Queen. And the Lord had laid it on my heart, because she really don't understand when she says, Mama, it don't matter what you get me. I didn't want to go to Charlotte Russe and get a pair of shoes. I didn't want to go to Forever 21 and get an outfit, you know, because I know it don't matter to her, but to me, it's like she could have whatever, you know what I'm saying? And but what I could do was from my heart, you know, with love. And also, I can't tell y'all what the other surprise is, because then she'll know about it. So, but love bugs and love muffins. I am not gonna eat like this. Now, I'm gonna be honest with y'all. I tasted my mac and cheese and I tasted my dressing. I'm not gonna mess with the pork chops. And I could have some green beans and white potatoes, but I'm not gonna, that's it. I just had a taste of my dressing and the mac. Cause you know, you always got to test that. I'm sorry. But I just wanted to, I'm gonna take this to them, to Queen and Clarence, and this is the place I made. So this is one of this. Both of these are theirs. I know I made a lot because it's a lot of food left, you know, for the family. But I wanted these plates separate. God, I hope I could close them. Anyway, I will. I'm gonna tape them. But this is the pork chops, smothered pork chops with the dressing, and these are Queen and Clarence's, and these are Queen and Clarence's. This is a mac and cheese, you all, with the green beans. I forgot to add rolls. I forgot my rolls, but the plate up under here is the same thing as I just showed you. So, yeah. So this is chunky Queen. She's chunky.
I'm really happy, oh y'all, and that I got some home cooked meal for my mom. But mom, I want you to try my pie. This is my
first. My God, that looks so good.
And you on a diet?
Okay, so y'all know I've been on my diet, right? And I've been doing so good. But it's sweet potatoes.
It was my first time making my pie.
Oh my God, Queen, this is so good. Hold on,
for the camera. She tried my pie, y'all, for the first time. Is this your first time?
Oh my God, this is so good.
Is this your first time, like, cheating on your diet?
Oh yeah, I've been doing good, but I can't splurge today because I usually just eat salmon, and I ain't had nothing but a fish sandwich earlier. And I had a little bit of my sides.
This food smells good.
Queen, this is so good. Yeah. Oh my God.
It's my first time making
it. I never made a sweet potato pie before.
I did. I just wanted to try it.
Oh my God. Mm. So him.
And y'all, I'm gonna react to eating her food.
I came and got a treat too. Wow.
It's good.
It's good. It's not too sweet. It's not too, it's good. It's just right.
I'm gonna tell you my recipe. I look a mess right now.
This place is full, cause I ain't know who.
Thank you. It's just me, Patty, and Claire.
Oh, it's enough for him too.
Okay, thank you.
Because like I said, I didn't know who was there.
I couldn't wait.
All right, y'all, so as y'all can see.
I didn't eat all day waiting for this.
Really?
Yeah, I was waiting for this.
So she didn't eat all day cause her waiting on mommy food.
It's my first time in a long time having you cooking.
Yeah, so I just wanted to tell you that you have so much, you know?
So much what?
So much of everything. Like, I was telling my love bugs and love muffins that the best I could do is fix you a meal from me, because you could go to any restaurant and you could eat anybody's food to taste exquisite and everything else, but nothing like a mama's cooking, so.
Nothing like it. I can't wait. Can't wait. I'm excited.
I'm excited too.
Thank you.
I love you.
Love you too. Oh, I just got a cramp.
Oh, don't break the water. Y'all pray for Queen. I'm happy.
Me too. Smell good. I can't wait to go eat it.
So a smothered pork chop, and make sure put it in a microwave because it's gonna even cool down by now. Don't serve that like that.
I won't. It's warm though, but I won't.
Yeah, the pork chops is like a smother and stuff in the gravy, and it's laying on top of the dressing, and then there's one with the green beans, white potatoes, and mac and cheese.
Okay.
I did a little different recipe to my mac and cheese. Okay. So.
I'm excited to try it.
Yeah. Okay, y'all, so we're going to end this video.
See you guys, and I'm going to do a reaction eating her food.
All right. Love bugs. I love y'all. Peace out in Jesus' name.